paid advertisement for Fast and Furious Spy Racers.
Whew, I made it.
Welcome to What They Got Right. I'm your host, Samantha, and I want to learn everything there's to know about street racing. Lesson one, it's not about the car, it's about the driver. With that, let's zoom right into What They Got Right with Fast and Furious Spy Racers coming to Netflix.
They were fishing for remission, now they're zooming out of sight. Fast and Furious Spy Racers on What They Got Right.
Spy Racers is the Fast franchise's first animated series. But the show and the franchise are intertwined and actually exist in the same universe.
Because of that, everything in the show fits together with the movies. Some plot points were even changed to sync up with the movies.
They also share a major theme, family.
The show follows Dom's cousin, Tony Toretto, as he goes undercover to take on a criminal organization.
Originally, Tony and his crew were supposed to have a pretty straightforward rescue mission, but the show is called Spy Racers, and the creative team thought it would be awesome if there was a spy element to really emphasize the title.
So, they decided to start the show with the team getting introduced to a secret agency and then going undercover to investigate a criminal organization.
In episode 1, government agent Ms. Nowhere gets introduced to the Spy Racers.
Tony, the charismatic leader of the group. Cisco, the gearhead who's equal parts heart and muscle. Echo, the eco-friendly speedster who built an electric car that goes from 0 to 60 in 2.4 seconds. And the youngest member, Frosty the hacker. The creative team made sure to include a kid among the team of teenagers who would bring a youthful and comedic energy to the group. But the characters didn't always look the way they do now. They looked like this when they were in 2D. Once they were made into computer graphics, the characters changed into the ones we see now. Sleek, smart, and ready to roll.
Now you might be wondering, who's the girl in the red jacket? That's Layla.
Layla is a talented racer who works with the bad guys. But originally, she was supposed to be an undercover spy who would help Tony and the Spy Racers.
But if Layla and Tony were working together as spies, their arguing alone would blow their cover. Now they're opposing forces, so when they butt heads, it totally makes sense.
Another change to Layla was that in early versions of the story, her cover identity was a famous social media star.
But it was a smart move to drop this idea. Spies need to be cool, discreet, and off the radar, and they definitely can't tag their locations. No matter what though, Layla was always going to be a bold and independent street racer, and we get to see her shake things up for the Spy Racers from the start of the series. One thing that all the characters have in common?
The show created all new vehicles just for them. So watch for rides you've never seen before. You can't make a spy show without cool spy technology. We're talking about things like a purse that turns into a zipline or a tiny mirror that can shut down the engine of a car. I'd be careful with that one. Nothing is worse than causing a traffic jam.
Premiering December 26th, there's no show quite like Fast and Furious Spy Racers. All of that is made possible by the talented people that came together, just like Tony and his crew, to create the story and stunning visuals of Universal and DreamWorks' new show. Thanks again to DreamWorks Animation for funding this episode, and thanks for watching What They Got Right. Be sure to check out Fast and Furious Spy Racers coming to Netflix. And don't forget to subscribe to DreamWorks TV for new videos every single day. Until next time, that's my ride.